Investigative journalist John Grobler has been investigating the plundering of our forest for a few years now, and he explains that there may have been more than just wood found in these trucks that he followed all the way to Walvis Bay.
I was tipped off that, you know, they found two containers belonging to this hoe who operates out of Rundu, containing some anomalous sharp pointy things sticking out, you know. And this was confirmed by, you know, several good sources. And so what I think would happen is that, you know, I'd started making noise about those trucks being moved. It was like that load of five that, you know, we saw. You can see, I had the pictures, I posted the pictures of Joseph Ayilwa clearing those guys through the Murirani gate. You know, he basically arrived there before the trucks, made sure that everything went smoothly, off they went. You know, since when as a director of forestry to this? And, you know, it's the pattern throughout, you know. It's a highly, highly organized criminal syndicate. Bribes are being paid routinely. Throughout.
My calls to the Director of Forestry, Joseph Heilwell, went unanswered. Many Namibians don't understand the true value of our natural resources, and so I asked investigative journalist John Grobler to explain just why it is that we need to protect these resources.
Why do you think the rain is staying away? You know, these huge old plants, I mean, they're all part of a very delicate, very brittle ecosystem that we occupy here. And this is why I think the rains have been getting really, really erratic. Apart from, you know the climate changes, all of that, but it's, you have these highly localized storms these days, you know, really erratic. And it has to do with the forest canopy disappearing, because these are, there's a reason why the Amazon and the Congo is our lungs. This is how the system works. People don't get that. The lack of rain is due to this stuff happening all over, and it's insane. Yeah, it's all based on speculation. I don't think everybody in China wants a piece of homeware furniture. I think it's a very handy way for lots of dirty money to get washed, because it's cash in this end, and there is chaos. We don't really know what's going on.